Greetings, Spokane. I'm State Senator Michael Baumgartner. Thank you for joining me for this week's video update from Olympia. This is the 12th week of the legislative session of 2011. This week started with a very special event for all those interested in celebrating a lifetime of public service in Washington. That's because I joined a large group of past and present legislators, community leaders, and friends and family to celebrate the life of the recently deceased Senator Bob McCaslin. Bob McCaslin spent 30 years in the state Senate fighting for property rights, lower taxes, and less government expansion as a senator representing the Spokane Valley. He passed away on Sunday, March 13th, at the age of 84, and I was honored to attend his memorial service this past weekend at University High School out in the Spokane Valley. It was great to see members of both chambers and both parties join together to remember and honor Senator McCaslin. It is a testament to his impact on the Senate that he was so well respected by members of both parties, Democrats and Republicans. As just one example, after the service, I traded stories about the life of the remarkable Bob McCaslin with both Senator Adam Klein of Seattle, who is one of the most liberal members of the Senate, and Dino Rossi, who is known as a very conservative member when he served here in the Senate. Both hold him in very high regard. I never had the pleasure of serving with Senator McCaslin, as he resigned his Senate seat in January because of ill health, just as I was being sworn into office. However, his spirit and humor are still alive and well in this place, preserved in the memories and stories of those who come to love him and came to respect him. Truly, Senator McCaslin brought a great deal of value to Olympia. Unfortunately, I'm finding during my short time here in the legislature that often value is something in short supply in Olympia. To see what I mean, this week's Thinking About Smarter Government features a short field trip. Hi everybody. The reason I brought you outside for part of this week's video is not because I wanted to show you what the weather's like here in Olympia. It rains a lot here. But the reason I brought you outside is because I wanted to give you a picture of something to think about as we consider this important issue of how does our state spend money and does it spend money with value? Now, we heard last week the state's going to have a $5.1 billion budget shortfall. So there's not enough money for everything the state wants to spend money on. And some folks out there think that we need to have the state raise even more revenue than the record revenue that we have coming into the state. But before I engage that, let's think about how good a job the state is doing at spending money with the money it has now. And unfortunately, I've found since my short time legislature, the state doesn't do a good job in spending our hard-earned tax dollars with value. And here's a perfect example. The building behind me is a new, under construction, $300 million marble-clad building to house the state's IT infrastructure. So let's think about two things with this building. First, let's think about the cost. $300 million in a building sided with marble, beautiful underground parking spaces, beautiful indoor suites. Folks, the Safeco Field was built for $500 million, and the state is building a building to house our computers and our IT infrastructure, basically a server farm, for $300 million. So first, there's a cost issue with this. I don't think that's good value for our hard-earned tax dollars. Secondly, let's think about what this building does. Any private business, when they're looking at the business decision, any sizable private business, I should say, when they're looking at the business decision to house their own IT infrastructure or to outsource that infrastructure, usually chooses outsourcing because it's not a core competency of that private business. So they'd hire a private company to run their server farms and to manage their IT systems. Just go and ask anybody that you know that runs a business that's more than 50 people. They won't house their own IT infrastructure. So we ask ourselves the question, is this even a line of work that the state should be in? And I would challenge our legislature and say to you, the voters and the taxpayers back home, that at a time of limited resources, the state shouldn't be in the IT business. This is Washington State. We have great software companies. We have great technology companies. There are plenty of companies in this state that could be managing and running and doing a better job of housing our IT infrastructure than the state. Now, one other point to remember about this building at a time we're fighting for scarce capital dollars here. Is should we be building a $300 million building in Olympia to house the state's IT infrastructure at the same time we're fighting hard to find $70 million for an important new medical school in Spokane that's going to train doctors to help in all of rural eastern Washington and in Spokane itself? So again, not enough money for everything. Let's stop spending money on projects like these so we can put the money where it really belongs. So let's go back inside and we'll finish up some more of this week's update. Just think about how many better things the state could spend $300 million on. A marble-plated server farm for a non-essential government function that could be much better served at a much better price by the private sector? That's not value, and it's certainly not smarter government. Well, that's almost all the time we have for this week. But before I go, I want to say a special thank you to the members of the Ferris High School Leadership Class, many of whom visited Olympia this week. Back in October, Jennifer Walter's class, which is sometimes described as the best of the best in Spokane, hosted a debate between me and then-Senator Chris Marr. I was impressed by the hard work and professionalism of these young leaders. Many of the students have stayed in touch with my office since the election, and it is with great joy and pride that I was able to show them around Olympia. During their visit, the Ferris High School Leadership Class received an issue briefing from the Washington Policy Center, toured the Capitol, met with Supreme Court Justice Jim Johnson, Lieutenant Governor Brad Owen, Secretary of State Sam Reed, and the entire 6th District legislative team. They also had an opportunity to give their views to me on some important policy discussions about higher education funding here in the state. Ferris High School Leadership Class, it was great seeing you all, and I look forward to seeing you become the next generations of leaders in our state. Mrs. Walter, keep up the great work. If you know of a high school class that might enjoy a visit to Olympia, please be in touch with my office. It's always great to have Spokane's young people pay us a visit here in the state's capital. Until next time, thank you once again for the honor and privilege of serving you in the Washington State Senate. I'm Michael Baumgartner.